Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great week, folks. Great month. Cultivate wisdom. You don't need to accumulate knowledge to become wise. Anyone can become wise. When you become wise, you respect your body, you respect your mind, and you respect your soul. When you become wise, your life is controlled by your heart, not your head. Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 406. You get NASDAQ up 140. S&P's up 40. That's a gain of 1.7% in the NASDAQ, 1.5% in the Dow, and 1.3% in the S&P's. Gold. Gold contract down $33, trading at $15.27 an ounce. You got silver down 70 cents, $18.84 an ounce. Light sweet crude down 18 cents, $56.08 a barrel. And if we go over and take a look at this oil, because oil spiked up into the 57 area out here, and that area is basically they're selling it hand over fist. So you had a larger drawdown with the oil numbers at 11 o'clock today. It spikes all the way up to the 57.76. So your last high out here was 57.40. Guess what? Gave it up in spades. And you just don't have the volume behind the move also. So you got to a higher high, and what's sticking out like a sore thumb now is the lows that were established out here on Tuesday at 52.84. Oil still, guess what? Plenty of oil. This thing was wants to make a charge down to $50.56. Pretty wild, actually. Particularly because you had a large drawdown, folks, in the oil market. It spikes first, and then the sellers just came in hand over fist. Notes and bonds. Bottom line is that, yes, the notes and bonds pull back today. Not enough volume. These still want higher price. You pull back almost a full point in the 10-year. Right now, we are trading at 131.09. We were down at 131.02, and you've done 1.7 million contracts. Now, if we take a look at this, what you're going to see is that you're going into 2.4 million. And if I just bring this back, because this is what you have to actually do when you're looking at this. You have to bring it back because these contracts roll. And if you bring it back to the last contract, what you're going to see is that the amount of volume that it's going to take to basically destroy this uptrend is pretty intense. Because when we went up, it was 3.1 million contracts we were going after right now. And we were coming into that with less than 2 million. No, let's go to the 30-year also, and I'm going to bring up the last contract that we were trading so we can get the volume on that. Okay, so we bring this up. So the 30-year had, okay, 577,000 contracts and 570. So you're coming into 570, and we are coming into 570 with 394. And you haven't even reached a swing point yet. So bottom line, that's still saying that, guess what? You're going to need more selling to break down that bond market. King dollar. King dollar is down with 33 ticks here at 50 contracts. I'd say that's light contract volume, folks. King dollar is setting up a doji. We'll see if this is just the middle of the move and then it's trying to get down inside, once again, this 97.715 area. So what we had done yesterday is this. You got below the high that you had taken out on last week. That high was 98.700. Bottom line, you get really a sideways market down here today. You had a low out here of 98.03. You had a high of 98.515. So you had a half penny move. We'll see how this baby shakes out. The euro. Let's go to the euro because the dollar is all about the euro and the pound right now. The euro got up to a price point today of 110.85 and closed out at 110.36. The pound. We go take a look at the pound out here. What the pound did, oh, this is going to be strong. Yeah, this dollar is going to have a hard time. The pound strong. The pound actually just broke the downtrend from 127. Let me see if it's actually bigger than that. Let me just see this. It's actually probably bigger than this. Let's see. Yeah, it is. So the pound just broke the downtrend from 131, and we are at 123. And this is a break with conviction. You went into the trend line with conviction. Yesterday, we went from 122 to 120. We went from 120 to 122.58. And now we hit a high today of 123.54. Yeah, that's a decisive break, folks, in the pound. Let's go take a look at the XLE, since what you had is that you had the physical oil market give it up. XLE out here, bottom line, not much behind the move. XLE is up 11 million shares, 11 million is going into 27 million, so big numbers. S&P, let's go take a look at this S&P. So the S&P, folks, coming right into the downdraft that had been created out here on the 1st and 2nd of August. You got an expansion of volume, 61 million shares traded out here. Let me set that up for you again. There we go. That should do it, I think. We're going in with 61 million. You're up $4.06 right now. You're coming into a Friday. We have jobs numbers tomorrow. So realistically, more than likely, when you're this close to a small swing high, we're at a small swing high at $300.87. That's where we came down from on the 1st. You can expect it's going to go up and test that area. The all-time high right now is 302.23. That's your S&Ps. We go take a look at the NDX 100, the 3Qs. 3Qs right now, 25 million shares. That baby's coming at the 63 million. You're trading 191.84, and same kind of setup. You know, this can basically get up into this 194 level. Small caps, still the weakest indice out here. You're up $3 right now. Bottom line, though, compared to the other two indices, you get some weakness here. In fact, let's just go look at the Dow. I'll show you the Dow from the highs to where we are right now. Dow Industrials, you know, we're talking a high of 27,398, and you're 26,761. The Dow's, well, Dow, S&P, and NASDAQ, they're all slamming right into this downdraft. Some of the higher volume equities out here. You have the chip stocks moving out here pretty extensively today. You got Intel up $1.25. Microsoft's up $2. Apple's up $4. Cisco's up $1. The banks. The banks are going to get interesting here. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.